success is something that it comes from deep inside our heart. We need to define clearly. Success in journey is never destination, in my opinion. Success, in my opinion, is about how much value that we could bring for the people around us.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Yang terhormat Menteri Tenaga Manusia Encik Tan Kim Leong, Editor Berita Harian dan Berita Minggu Encik Muhammad Guntur Sadali, Speaker of Parlimen Encik Abdullah Tan Muki, yang saya kasihi dan hormati Ibu dan Ayah Haji Shamsuddin dan Haja Salimah, bersama keluarga, sahabat-sahabat dan saudara mara. Semua teman-teman media masa, hadirin dan hadirat, selamat malam, salam sejahtera untuk kita semua. Marilah kita memanjatkan puji syukur kepada Tuhan Yang Maha Esa, kerana dengan barakah dan rahmahnya, kita sama-sama dapat menghadiri Majlis Anugerah Jauhari 2010. Saya ingin mengambil kesempatan ini untuk mengucapkan ribuan terima kasih saya kepada kaki tangan ataupun karyawan Berita Harian yang telah menjayakan majlis pada malam ini, khususnya kepada Encik Nazri Hadi, juga kepada Encik Lingli dan Encik Tukiman yang telah berkunjung ke rumah kami pada bulan Jun yang lepas. Terima kasih. Saya juga ingin mengatakan tokoh-tokoh yang telah disebutkan sebentar tadi oleh Menteri adalah tokoh-tokoh yang sangat kita kenali, dan tokoh-tokoh inilah yang menjadikan saya inspirasi untuk mencapai kejayaan. Tokoh-tokoh ini dapat kita kenali hanya kerana adanya platform yang disediakan oleh Berita Harian. Saya mengajak hadirin dan hadirat supaya kita sama-sama memberikan penghargaan kepada Berita Harian yang telah mengusahakan peranan ini selama 12 tahun, khususnya kepada Menteri Muhammad Guntur Sadali, Menteri Saad Abdul Rahman, Menteri Zulkifli dan semua sekalian Berita Harian. Hadirin dan hadirat, oleh kerana adanya ramai di antara kita yang mungkin kurang fasih dalam bahasa Melayu, izinkan saya meneruskan ucapan saya dalam bahasa Inggeris. Mr. Tan Kim Leong, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, success, in my opinion, has always been a journey. It is never, in my point of view, a destination. It is all about how we can add value to the people. It is all about how we can bring success not to an individual, but is to the community at large. Please allow me to share with you few learnings that I have while going through CAFOR in Singapore, Malaysia, and also Indonesia. I started working in CAFOR Suntec City in 1996. Right after my graduation, many of my friends asked me, why do you have to join CAFOR? What is CAFOR? By the way, CAFOR is a French word. It means a crossroad. And this gives me an idea, a crossroad. Each time we need to think where we need to make our choices. That was the beginning of understanding about Kafir in my life. I work on the ground with the people. I carry goods, fill up the shelves, cleaning the gondolas, counting stocks. And people were laughing at me at the time. You are a graduate. Why are you doing such things? And I discover truly who I am. I think this is something that all of us has to have a good reflection about ourselves. Working in a company like this, small, one of the smallest country that Kafir has all over the world, I wonder, how am I going to be noticed? I would like to grow. I would like to progress. But how can I be noticed if, first and for me, one person working very hard in Singapore, out of 28 countries that Kafir is present worldwide, how can I be noticed? This is something that I discovered while working in Kafir. One day, in 2003, I asked my then CEO in Kafir Singapore, Mr. Luke Dario, "Sir, at which level of the highest position that I could be, could I be a CEO like you?" And he said, "Well, Shafie, you are good, but we are a French multinational, and we have never given an opportunity to a non-French and Asian. Maybe it will be tough for you." Well, that was a wake-up call for me. I said that it is an opportunity for me. It is something that I will strive for, not only for myself, but for the hundreds and thousands of Asian people working in Kafir. We have Kafir in China, we have Kafir in Taiwan, we have Kafir in Indonesia, Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore, Japan at one time too. There is none an Asian that leads as a CEO. 2005, I was given a chance to lead Kafir Singapore as the managing director. 2006, they gave me a chance to lead Malaysia and Singapore. And that was the first real challenge that I got. Arriving in Malaysia, I was questioned by whom? Not only by the French, surprisingly, it is also by the Malaysians. They were asking me these 3 points. How come you are leading Kafir in Malaysia and Singapore? Number one, you are not French. Number two, you are too young. 35 years old. How can you be a CEO? Number three, you have no experience as a CEO. At that time I was 35 years old. I gathered the people. At that time, I gathered about 500 people and I told them, "Please, I cannot change those 3 points even if you want me to do it. I cannot be French. I cannot be older if you want me to be." I was 35 at that time. "And I cannot be experienced if I don't have any experience as a CEO. But one thing I would like to ask from you," I told them, "can you just be neutral? Do not judge now. Give me 6 months. After 6 months, if you don't think that I'm capable to lead all of you, I will tender my resignation. But one thing that I will give you, I will give you my heart. Give me a chance to lead you and I will give you my heart." And alhamdulillah, after 6 months, they accepted me. They gave me a chance. I owe my success to all the people around me. Moving forward, I started in Indonesia a year ago. Again, there was an opportunity. Mr. Hassan from Mercy Relief had many choices to make to ask for help. But fortunately, he called me up and said, would you be able to render help with Mercy Relief? I took the chance and once again shows the principles of sharing, the principles of how we can bring value to others by working with the right organization at Mercy Relief. I thank Hassan for giving me that opportunity. Thank you, Hassan. Through my journey from 1996 to now, I discover a few things. Number one, who we are today is what we chose yesterday. Who we are tomorrow is what we have to choose today. I reminded this every time I move from one place to another. Who and what is a dream that we have to make the choice. Choice is an action with responsibility and accountability. And time is never going to wait for us. That's why I always say, a leader has to make a stand. Maybe it's tough. Maybe it's not popular. Maybe people will not prefer us to do what we want to do. But if we believe in it, and if we do it with sincerity, if we do it with our heart, and I'm sure we will be able to achieve that success. So ladies and gentlemen, once again, I'm here tonight to receive this award, Brita Harian Achievers Award of 2010. I will receive it with trust, with responsibility, and most importantly, with sincerity. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.